After taking in the beauty of Nairobi, we're now heading to the north of Kenya on a safari adventure. Our destination is Nanyuki. Today, we join millions of tourists to ply this popular route, just to discover why Kenya is regarded as a safari destination of Africa. Not long, cityscape seamlessly fades into beautiful greenery of countryside. After 2.5 hours drive, we made a rest stop at a courier shop. It is opened for tourists who love souvenir and artifacts to take back home. After stretching our legs, shopping, and having selfies with fans, we were back on the road. Our next stop was at the Equator Line on the outskirts of Nanyuki, a spot popular with tourists who get themselves photographed.
We just had to make a stop here at Nanyuki.
This is one of the spots the equator cuts across Kenya.
Stay with us.
If time permits, tourists also get to watch the locals perform an experiment to explain how the Coriolis effect works.
Hi there, viewers. We're going to have a demonstration of how the equator affects our everyday life. So, what happens here?
We are going to carry out a scientific test about how water is affected by the equator. Okay. Once you move to the northern hemisphere, to okay. the south, at the center of the earth.
Okay.
You find that if you pour water in this bowl, you let it drain through this hole, well, we are 20 meters north, you see that as the water drains down, always the rotation takes the clockwise direction. You move to southern hemisphere, the same distance is going to behave the opposite, anti-clockwise.
Oh, yeah.
Then, when you come exactly at this point, all the rotation would stop, and then the water is pulled straight down. So 20 meters is the minimum distance whereby you can notice the changes. So maybe we can start from north, cross to south, and then finish up right on the line.
Oh, okay.
So,
sure, let's see how it works.
Let's move to north.
Let's go.
Yeah. Alright, so this is the point. Here is the point whereby the changes start showing.
So right here, this we are in the north.
20 meters north.
Okay.
So all we have to do is just to let the water settle down and then we release it like in a water tap. So this way is now spinning, and because you can't see the direction, we place down this piece of sticks to show us the direction. So this way is clockwise.
Okay.
So the far you go to the north or to the south, the stronger the force, or rather the faster the rotation. And if you lift up the ball, you watch out as the water trends down, you can see the spirals at northern side. They always coil at clockwise. This is like the way you open water tap or you flush the toilet at this side, the water drains clockwise direction.
That's right.
So this force that keeps all this difference is known as Coriolis effect. Or
it's known as what?
Coriolis force or Coriolis effect.
Okay.
Coriolis, being the man who discovered this, is effective to the wind systems, ocean currents, and climbing vines. You find that vines at northern side of the equator always grow at clockwise, south vines grow at counterclockwise. So let's watch at southern side, 20 meters from the line.
Okay.
Yeah. Right, so now we are at around 20 meters south on M Spear, whereby you're going to release down the water. So at this point, the rotation would take anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. You place down again the sticks. So this way is counterclockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
Wow.
So as well, the farther we move to the south, the faster the rotation is going to be.
So the farther we move away from the equator,
the faster
it rotates.
Yeah, or the stronger the force.
The stronger the force.
We also have the spirals of the water having changed at this point. You see they coil at counterclockwise.
Yes.
So if you happen to open water taps at this side of the equator, south is always going to behave anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
So when you come to the point of equator, due to the balancing of the two forces, there will be no rotation and the water is going to be pulled straight down on the line. So let's prove that.
Okay, let's see how it works.
Yeah, let's go to the line.
So right now we are on the line.
On the line.
Let's see how it works here.
All right, so at this particular point, any kind of movement may either be caused by the wind, like today is too much wind. So the sticks may either go one way or the other, but no uniform rotation. That means here is neutral, no rotation, and the water is straight down. If you look at this part of the water, you see straight down and no rotation. Even if you try maybe to force the sticks, go either way, and there is no rotation. So that means you are right on the line.
So because we are right on the line, the stick in the water is no longer rotating.
It's not rotating.
It's stationary.
This is just to show whether the water is rotating or not. If you put it like that, it doesn't rotate on the equator. That means you are right on the line. So use this method in case maybe you get lost somewhere. You don't know which world you are. Then you just use the apparatus to find whether you are either side.
So right now we are on the line.
We are on the line.
All right, viewers.
Yeah.
So viewers, this is the real deal.
Our trip lasted more than usual, but we finally made it to our base at Sweetwater's Serena Camp. Our quest to view the Big Five continued the following day at Opageta Conservancy.
Yes, we're in Opageta and we're about to take a game drive.
And we hope to see the Big Five.
Mm-hmm. After all, this is Kenya. Mm-hmm. But who knows what the Big Five are?
I do.
Okay.
Let me hear them.
Elephants.
Lion.
Buffalo.
Leopard.
Rhinoceros.
Wow!
Yes! So, come with us, come with us!
Situated between Mount Kenya and the rolling hills of Abadares, Opageta is one of the best and only four private game conservancies for big game viewing in the country. All Pajeta boasts of the largest black rhino sanctuary in East Africa, hosts the only chimpanzee sanctuary in Kenya, and shelters a large number of rare and endangered species. We set out at the crack of dawn to view the big five games, which include lion, elephant, cape buffalo, leopard, and rhinoceros. As our quest took us through trails, greenery and rolling hills, countless animals were captured on our camera lens. Out of the big five, we were pleased to see cape buffalo, elephant, and black rhino. And from game driving, we moved on to the northern white rhino sanctuary. Getting close to these endangered species requires briefing from trained caretakers.
So wherever we are going now is the endangered species enclosure. It's a place where we have animals that are endangered in nature. Mm-hmm. Way inside we have the gravy zebras and the Jackson's artbeasts, which are, you know, endemic to Laikipia only, and they're endangered with a population of like less than 3,000 for both gravy and Jackson's artbeasts.
Okay.
And then we have the northern white rhinos, which they are the critical endangered species of rhinos on Earth presently, with only 3 left in the whole world.
The whole world?
Yeah. So the rhinos present here are 2 northern white rhinos and a southern white rhino. The northern white rhinos are Najin and Fatu by names respectively. Najin is 27 years old and Fatu is 16 years old. And the southern white is between 17 to 18 years old. Primarily the southern white was meant to induce the natural instinct of the northern white when they came from the zoo, because they couldn't do much by natural. So we had to put them together, help them know how to wallow on mud, graze on grass, and eventually become more natural rhinos with time.
Thereafter came the high point of our visit, to pet and take selfies with Najin and Fatu, the last surviving population of wild northern white rhinos. Thank you.
Basically, the northern white rhinos have stayed a long time in the zoo. And you know, in the zoo, there's so much human, you know, interaction, like they're being fed directly. So this made them like to be much accustomed to be with people. That is why they're comfortable with people being around. It's not much of a bother when you see, because you see they are grazing comfortably. They don't seem to be bothered by our presence. So this they got accustomed all the way from in their zoo, because the two females we have here were born in the zoo. And Sudan stayed a long time in the zoo as well, because he was born in Sudan and taken to the zoo when he was between 2 to 3 years old, when he was captured. So he spent so much time and got accustomed to be with people. They are aggressive at some point, we can easily tell, and we can easily be able to stop them. We know how we calm them. We know how we can call them when we see there's signs of aggression. Definitely you see them becoming more jumpy. They will swell their tails, and like swelling their tails in an effect that shows they are agitated. They will be lifting their heads up and their ears pointing forward. That is a sign of charging at any time. So with that time, you also see like they're like also aggressive. They will be trying to, you know, run and jump around. So at that time, that is when we can try to contain them. So those are the few signs that you can see that, you know, they're not in that good mood.
In the end, we all had a great day.
I've actually never seen a rhino in the wild. This is my first time, and especially being able to get so close and just to see how beautiful they actually are in person was really, really cool for me.
From there, we moved on to enjoy the company of rescued chimpanzees and to learn about their stories of torture in captivity in West and Central Africa before they were rescued. Established in 1993, the sanctuary is now home to 37 chimps, divided into two groups.
We have 37 chimpanzees in total, and we have them in two groups. The group of safari, which you see in front of us here, is there are 23 chimpanzees together, 11 males and 12 females. And they have a very huge enclosures. This group, they have like 100 acres, and they wander around. Although they don't rely on themselves, they don't get enough food in the wild, we do supplement them. We buy them fruits, all the fruit, bananas, oranges, mangoes, pawpaws, and they have where they are fed. There is a house somewhere about a kilometer away from here, and they go for lunch, they go there for dinner, and they go to sleep as well.
Our experience with these primates was memorable, considering the antics of Safari and Coco, the two alpha male chimps. While Safari enjoys posing for selfies with celebrities,
now this is Safari. He's 32 years old, and he's a great friend. He was just taking turns to pose for pictures.
That's right.
For everyone here.
Wow, he's so handsome.
Hi, Safari. You're so cute.
Coco is a show freak.
Showman, like you just saw what he did, but I like Safari. Safari is warm, poses for the picture, mm-hmm. for everyone. Yeah, he was very patient and waited for everyone to take their turns doing pictures. But like, Poco was just, oh please, I don't want. Then let me just show you guys who I am. I'm the stuff I'm made of. And he stood up and started hitting his chest.
Walking with his two legs.
Yes, and he's the only one that does that.
Visitors to the chimpanzee sanctuary can choose to adopt one. Our last lap of safari in Kenya was a visit to Mount Kenya Wildlife Conservancy. The The location plays a great role in conserving critically endangered mountain bongo, one of the most beautiful antelopes in Kenya.
We take care of the sick animal, the orphaned, and more to that also, we breed endangered species. But all the animals that we care for in these animal orphanage, mostly we do release them back to the wild.
Our visit here affords us the opportunity to have fun with domesticated animals, including cheetah, crested crane, lynx, llama, rock hyrax, mangaboon, amongst others. But the greatest fun lies in hand-feeding a baby oryx or allowing a giant ostrich to feed from your head.
Now, we're right here at Mount Kenyan Animal Orphanage, okay? And all the animals here have been domesticated.
As we bid goodbye to Nanyuki, we couldn't but marvel at this true nature's wonderland. It is an ultimate destination every tourist should experience. The diversity of game viewing in Kenya is simply astounding. No wonder nature lovers are easily lost in the beauty of this great land.
Aye, aye. Aye. Aye.
It has been a roller coaster adventure, and we'll finally come to the end of it all.
Yes, 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 and it all happened right here in Kenya. You know, it's Goge Africa on Waka Kenya Adventure. And if you had as much fun as we did, I'd like to keep a date with you, perhaps, right here in Kenya.
Sure. See you sometime next week. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.